There's a drink, which varies from an almost neutral taste to a full malt taste and everything in between. William of Orange took the drink to Britain when he was asked to be king. Here the English added lots of juniper tree berries to it and therefore became the English variation. This is the never-ending story of Geneva in the Netherlands. Geneva is mostly made from barley and rye, and because we need those in large quantities, we use, besides the grains we grow ourselves, also the ones from overseas, from the Baltic. In these specially equipped sailing ships, we brought back barley and rye, the woods we needed for the distilleries, and one of the best juniper tree berries in the world. It all became a world-famous drink when it was industrialized in the 18th century. This was done in the town which almost gave her name to the drink,
Schiedam, or, as the English pronounce it, Schiedam.
This relative small town began to make Geneva in the beginning of the 16th century, but in large quantities during the 17th, 18th and 19th century, and became the biggest producer of spirits in the world. The remains of this illustrious past you can still witness today. As you walk down the canals, you can still imagine the barrels standing waiting to be shipped to the far east or west. When the young Dutch drink alcohol, they prefer mixed drinks, like for instance vodka with lemonade. But when they get older, they begin to appreciate to drink vodka in Geneva pure.
Welcome to Schiedam, the Geneva capital of the Netherlands. My name is Rob Verklaarwater and I'm going to tell you all about the spirits and how it is made. As you can see, we are now standing in one of the largest mills of Schiedam. We used to have 24 of them, now we only have 5. But they still grind the grain for the distilleries and also for the bakers. After this, you need, of course, porters to carry the sacks to the distilleries. So, let's go to the porter's house.
This is the porter's or bearer's house. When the bell was rung, the porters had 7 minutes time to get into the house. When somebody came later than that, they were not allowed to throw the dice. And that meant they didn't have work, because he who had the highest score after the throwing got the job. The sack carrying guild was called St. Anthony and dates from 1464. The porters carried the sacks of malted barley and rye flour from the mill into the distillery.
Here in the old town of Schiedam in the heart, there is the distilled museum. And they still got a burnery, like they call it. It's a sort of a distillery with 3 pot stills. And Jacco van der Leun is going to show us how this was working in the old days. Ah, Jacco, how are you doing?
Hi Rob, very well, thank you.
What are you working at the moment?
I am measuring the amount of liquor I've got in this big barrel.
Yeah.
One moment, please.
So, how many liters does this contain?
At the moment, 2,000 liters of traditional malt wine.
Ah, this is very nice. Can you show us?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, this is nice. This is the mother of all Geneva.
We produced this here for centuries in Schiedam.
So there were over 400 of these pot stills and distilleries?
Yeah, in the 19th century, whole Schiedam was Geneva.
Huh.
And I will show you how we made that here.
So this is the mother of all Geneva?
Yes.
And you're going to show us how it was made?
Yes.
It will be great. He's going to show us.
Every distillery in Schiedam had 3 pot stills, each one with his own purpose. They're all fired with coal, which makes it not only a very dirty, but also a job where the distiller had to be very precise and attentive. In these wooden open barrels, the rye flour is mixed with hot water. And when the mixture is cooled down to approximately 25 degrees Celsius, the malt flour is added as well. This batter, where we also put in some amount of yeast, is stirred or mixed for some time. because of the enzymes, the wonder starts. After a few days, the batter already contains approximately 6% alcohol and some carbon dioxide. But we are only interested in the alcohol, and therefore we are now going to distill the alcohol out of the mix by heating up the batter in these beautiful old pot stills. Distillation is none other than increasing the temperature of a liquid until its various components, each at its own temperature, evaporates. During the distillation, the bad alcohol, the methyl alcohol, is distilled out of the liquid. The good alcohol, the ethyl alcohol, has a higher point of evaporation and therefore evaporates later when the still is heated up even more. We're off to start the process of distillation. By way of this overflow system, the liquid, which now contains 12% alcohol, now flows into a ground barrel. After the second distillation, we have an alcohol percentage of 24%, and after the third one, we finally made our malt wine, which contains 48% alcohol. This malt wine is now put in these oak barrels to be taken to the final distillery, when we distill it again, but not after we added juniper tree berries and all kinds of herbs, berries, roots, spices, nuts and fruits.
During the 17th and 18th century, the Dutch VOC, the United East Indies Company, traveled to the Far East, to Indonesia, to fetch herbs and spices, and the hold was full of those when they came back. And for dinner they had bread, porridge, fishes, cheeses, but the most important, beer and wine. And two times a day it was a party, because then they got the Geneva to keep up the spirits. As you can see, this is the dinner for the officers. Chicken, vegetables, wine, beer, and of course, a lot of Geneva. Can you imagine sailing on those ships to the Far East, to South Africa, South America, Ceylon, Indonesia, Batavia, even Australia, New Zealand? And then imagine the smells and the diseases. And after months and months at sea, and suffered from all illnesses, at last, land ahead!
Here in Amsterdam, the herbs and spices were also used in several other drinks, like liqueurs and so-called bitters. The Dutch East Indies Company were the biggest firm of shipholders and trading companies of the world. With the big profits they made, they decorated Amsterdam with these beautiful merchant houses.
We're now here in one of the oldest parts of Amsterdam, on our way to a distillery where they still distill in the old-fashioned way. And I wonder what they do with those herbs we just bought.
Here in the heart of Amsterdam, in the Jordaan, you can see that this profession goes not only from father to son, but in this case from father to daughter. Fanny van Wees is the only woman distiller of the Netherlands. She's one of those old-fashioned distillers who still tries to keep the old tradition alive. In this distillery, the malt wine is distilled again. And here you can witness daily how, with master skill, the last part of the making of Geneva is done.
This is called Jennifer Elixir. This is what is our own recipe, and we use it for most of our Genevas. And it's mostly herbs and flowers. The alcohol needs to go from a vaporized to fluid. Therefore it's in a spiral here inside. This one is filled with cold water, and therefore it goes from damp to liquid again. After the middle process of the Geneva, this one smells very nice. I'll let you smell something. You smell the herbs in this.
Oh, that's lovely. So all the herbs and seeds?
Mm-hmm. They're inside.
Yeah.
But the more you want to take out of your kettle,
it gets very bad because then the low smells that are in the herbs come out at the last part of the distillation process.
So you only want to have the first half?
Exactly.
As you can see, she's a very busy lady. But there are three pot stills at the moment working. So yeah, you have to be everywhere at the same time, which is, I think, it's impossible.
The herbs and spices are carefully mixed and measured so that every time the drink will have the same flavor and taste.
For the liqueurs, they also use star anise, cinnamon, orange peel, vanilla sticks, lavender, hazelnuts, cherries, peaches and apples, to name but a few. The mix of herbs and spices are put into a sack and are percolated in a pot still until these ingredients have given their flavor and tastes to the alcohol. Every step in the process is watched very carefully, and as you can see, the nose is the most important equipment a distiller has. To get the most out of the ingredients, the liquid is sometimes distilled again.
These are both coffees, but 80%. All those lovely smells. But I'm so very thirsty now. I want to taste it. Let's go taste it.
After all that hard work, the liquid is diluted with water and is then left to stand for at least 6 weeks while the flavors merge, and after that is put in a barrel.
Okay, we're in the cellar now, and in this cellar are about 12 types of our Genevas waiting to be older and older and older, and in this part, it's a very special part, here lie the 15 and 20 year old Genevas.
This is the treasure chamber of the distillery. Here the Geneva is aging. Sometimes it's more than 20 years before it's put in a bottle. The barrels themselves were used before for other drinks. This means that the barrel does not give a harsh color, taste or smell of wood to the Geneva, but gives it a gentle wooden and sometimes sweet vanilla taste to it, giving it an extra touch. Here everything is done by hand, from the barrel to these beautiful stone jugs. Every bottle catches a lot of attention. The bottles are even sealed with a wax stamp with the symbol of the distillery.
You have seen, these products are made with passion, and you never should mix with passion, don't you think?
Absolutely.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Come along, let's have a Geneva. Hi Joop.
Hi Robert. How are you doing?
Yeah, fine, you?
Thank you.
The regular, please.
How are you?
And not only Geneva they got, but also very nice meatballs. Well, this is one of the cafes where they serve these drinks. And very fine one as well. Cheers. Yeah. Cheers.
In Amsterdam, Schiedam, in fact everywhere in Holland, you can still find well-decorated and cozy pubs where many people meet each other and have a nice time.
Thank you very much. That's what I like. Dinner and a very nice drink. Cheers. Cheers. Now we're going to visit a modern distillery in Roosendaal, in the south of the Netherlands.
Because there wasn't enough room in Schiedam, this former Schiedam distiller moved to Roosendaal and restarted his distillery.
And as you can see, in the modern distillery, they also use a variety of the old-fashioned ingredients.
This is now one of the biggest distilleries in the Netherlands, with the biggest barrels of the Netherlands.
And this is the berry which gave the name to the drink Geneva, juniper tree berries.
Here they use a different way of getting the tastes into the liquid. A bag full of herbs is hung into the alcohol. This is called maceration. Because they make all kinds of drinks here, one of these big halls is filled with all kinds of pot stills.
In this distillery, they also use a distillation column, which was invented around 1900.
This made the old procedure obsolete. With this new invention, the making of alcohol was done in a fraction of the time that it took with the old method. Because of this, we now have young Geneva, made in the new way, containing less than 50% malt wine, old Geneva, mostly made in the old way, containing between 15% and 55% malt wine, and corn wine, which contains more than 55% malt wine. Each pot still has its own purpose. Here they use a lot of neutral alcohol to make all kinds of spirits, which are later put in Geneva, liqueurs, bitters or vodka. With a new method, it's also possible to make high-quality vodka in many varieties. This popular drink is exported all over the world.
Hi Eric, what are you doing here?
Here in the lab we are checking daily the quality of the products. For example, with this modern equipment we are checking the alcohol. We do that before bottling on the tanks and we do it during the bottling on the bottles itself.
So the alcohol control?
Yes.
But also the quality of the consistency?
The total quality of the consistency.
Okay. I'm terribly sorry, Eric, but this is a very traditional, old-fashioned way to check things. What are you doing here?
It's indeed a very traditional way. So we check the alcohol with a distillation method. It's a very old method, but we still use it to check the alcohol.
Okay. So you check it two times?
We check, double check our products.
Because of the large quantities of Geneva, the bottles are filled using the most modern equipment. Here we are witnessing how a container is filled with vodka. In this case, the vodka is a fruit vodka. Destination: Australia. Like in the old days, all kinds of Dutch drinks are now ready to be shipped to all corners of the world. This is done by trucks, trains and planes, but most of the time by boat. Drinks of the Netherlands and its specialty, the traditional drink of the Dutch, Geneva, are drinks which deserve to be rediscovered. Try it, because of the high quality and the large variety, there's a Dutch drink for everyone. Cheers!